हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ मिस्टर हरीश सदाशिव मोटेकर। आई एम योर सब्जेक्ट टीचर फॉर द सब्जेक्ट क्रिप्टोग्राफी एंड नेटवर्क सिक्योरिटी। एंड आवर टूडेज टॉपिक इज डिजिटल सिग्नेचर। ओके, सो बिफोर स्टार्टिंग विद द टॉपिक, लेट अस सी द लर्निंग ऑब्जेक्टिव्स। एंड द लर्निंग ऑब्जेक्टिव्स आर द आफ्टर लर्निंग दिस लेक्चर, स्टूडेंट विल बी एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड द कंसेप्ट ऑफ डिजिटल सिग्नेचर। सेकेंड वन इज the student will be able to understand the working of RSA algorithm, and third one is the student will be able to understand the working of DSS or DSA algorithm. So these are the learning objectives of the lecture. Now let us start with the introduction to the digital signature. So suppose we have two users, and one is sender and another one is receiver. Sender wants to send a message to the receiver, and for that he uses its own private key, so that he is using the private key for the encryption. On the other hand, receiver is receiving that key, message, and decrypting the message using the public key. So this technique where we are using private key for encryption, that known as the digital signature technique. We can understand this whole process using the diagram which is given below. So suppose we have a source, that is a sender suppose, and destination which is a receiver. So sender wants to send a message, that message is M. So he wants to send a message by using the digital signature technique. In that case, first he encrypts the message and generates a hash. Okay, that hash is then append with the message, and that part, that message is encrypted using the key, that is K. So we got a message that is encrypted with the key K. So it is a hashed message which is encrypted with the key. Okay, now that message is sent over the network, that is a secured network surely, and which is received by the destination or receiver. Okay, and the receiver first decrypt the message. Okay, he decrypt the message using the public key. See, you sender encrypt the message using the private key, receiver decrypt the message using public key, and now that message, we after decryption we get the message in which the first part is M, that is the message, and second part is what, hash, that we have seen earlier here. Okay, so that hash after the decryption. Okay, so now user will compare the hash with the existing one. Okay, and if the hash is same, then in that case we can say that the message is not corrupted, or it is a secured message or safe message. Okay, so this is known as the digital signature technique. Okay, so let us start with the types of the digital signature technique. Okay, digital signature technique can be of two types. Okay, so first one is the RSA and second one is a DSA or DSS. So RSA is an acronym, stands for Rivest, Shamir and Edelman. Okay, and the digital DSS stands for the DSA is stand for Digital Signature Standard, or DSS that is Digital Signature Standard, and DSA that is Digital Signature Algorithm. Okay, so these are the two types of the digital signature. Okay, so let us start with the first one, that is RSA. Okay, so the working steps of the RSA are given here. First, suppose Alice wants to send the message to the Bob using the RSA. So in that case, he will follow the following steps for the encryption. Okay, decryption as well. Okay, so consider the plain text message which is applied to the hash function to generate a hash code. Okay, here what we are doing, we are generating a hash code of the message. Now in second step, that hash code by using the public key. Okay, hash code is encrypted by using the public key. Okay,
एंड पब्लिक की ऑफ द एलिस विच इज अपेंड टू द प्लेन टेक्स्ट मैसेज एंड जनरेट द प्लेन टेक्स्ट मैसेज हैविंग अ एनक्रिप्टेड हैश. नाउ सेंड द मैसेज टू द नाउ सेंड दिस मैसेज टू द रिसीवर. ओके एट रिसीवर एंड सॉरी माय मिस्टेक हियर नॉट पब्लिक की. टू इनक्रिप्ट द मैसेज वील यूज द प्राइवेट की. इट इज अ स्मॉल मिस्टेक सो आई एम करेक्टिंग इट. द हैश विल बी एनक्रिप्टेड यूजिंग द प्राइवेट की ऑफ द एलिस. नाउ आफ्टर सेंडिंग दैट मैसेज टू द रिसीवर एट रिसीवर्स एंड द मैसेज विल बी डिक्रिप्टेड बाई यूजिंग द सेंडर्स और एलिस पब्लिक की. सो हियर वी आर यूजिंग द पब्लिक की टू द डिक्रिप्शन. हियर वी विल यूज प्राइवेट की फॉर द इनक्रिप्शन. ओके नाउ इट आफ्टर डिक्रिप्शन इट विल जनरेट अ हैश कोड. ओके दिस हैश कोड विल बी कंपेयर्ड विद द हैश कोड ऑफ द मैसेज. ओके सो इफ द बोथ हैश कोड्स आर सेम देन इट इज अ प्योर मैसेज. ओके नो नो अटैकर हैज अटैक्ड द मैसेज. ओके सो मैसेज इज इन ओरिजिनल फॉर्म. For the hash function, we use SHA-1 algorithm or SHA-512 algorithm for the hash function. Okay, so this is the working of the RSA algorithm. We can understand this working using the diagram. So the digital signature on RSA. Okay, so diagram of the RSA is given here. Okay, so let us start with the Alice, that is a sender, and Bob, that is a receiver. Okay, and Alice has a message. So Alice is doing what? He is making a digest, means he is applying the hash function to generate the hash code. Okay, so that hash code is generated here. Now that hash code is encrypted using the RSA encryption algorithm, or we can say the private key of the Alice. Okay, so Alice private key is used here to encrypt the message. Now this message will be sent to the receiver. Okay, so at the receiver send, message will be decrypted, or we can say the decryption is performed here by using the public key of the Alice. So public key of the Alice is used to decrypt the message. After decrypting the message, we'll get the digest, or that is also known as the hash code. Okay, now this hash code will be compared with the hash code of the message. Okay, and if the comparison is the output of the comparison is S, then it means the message is transmitted correctly, or no means message is not corrupted. Okay, if the answer is no, the output is no, it means that there is error in the message has been modified or forged. Okay, so this is the working diagram of the RSA algorithm. Okay, and as we have mentioned earlier, we use SHA-1 or SHA-512 algorithm for the as a hash function here. Okay, now let's start with the second part, that is DSS or DSA. Okay, so the DSS is the second type of the digital signature, and it is named as digital signature standard or the digital signature algorithm. Okay, suppose we have two users, Alice and Bob, again, and Alice wants to send the message to the Bob using DSA. In that case, consider the plain text message which is applied to the hash function and generated the hash code. Again, what we are doing, we are using the hash function to generate the hash code in the first step. Now with the hash code, a random number K is applied, okay, as an input and to the signature algorithm. Okay, so what we are doing, we are using a random number K, and with hash code we are applying this number to the as an input to the signature algorithm. After this, the signature will be used as PUG, that is global public element. Okay, global public element and that can be considered as public key. And second one is PRA, that is sender's private key. Okay, so this is PRA is sender's private key, and this is public global public element that can be considered as a public key. Okay, so these two things we will use for the signature. Next step is, now signature will be append with the message. Okay, now means we generate signature using hash code and random number. Now that signature will be append to the message here, so that we'll get a message which is signed, or we can say that with a signature having the components of S and R. Okay, signature components S and R. Okay, so this is the message. Now we'll send this message to the receiver, and at the receiver ends, what will happen? Let's see. Now in fifth step, now on the receiver's end, the first the hash function will be applied. Okay, sixth step is, along with the hash function, S and R also will be applied to the to verify the function. Okay, and here G is the global public element, and PUA will be applied. Okay, here we will use these two means we'll use the public key of the public key to decrypt the function. Okay, output of the verification function will be compared with the R, and as R is the major signature component. Okay, so what we'll do, after getting the output of this function, hash function, we'll apply the function, we will compare this that output means R with the existing R. So that is, R is the major signature component. Okay, so we can understand this whole process using the diagram. So what we are doing in the digital signature DSS approach, okay, sender sending the message using the DSS. So sender is doing what? First he applying a hash function to generate a hash code. Okay, now that hash code will be combined with a K. The K is a random number that will be used as a sign and a signature, and for that we will use PRA, that is the private key or secret key of the sender. Okay, so what we are doing, we are using three components, that is we are sending that three components, that is hash code, K is that is random number, and G is the global element. Okay, public global element, and that three things will be signed using the private key, that is PRA. Okay, private key or secret key of the sender. Now this sign or signature will be append to the message, and this will come create a message that is looks like this message M, that after that signature S and R. R is the major signing component. Okay, so signature has two components, S and R. Okay, now this message will be received by the receiver, and receiver at the receiver end, receiver will perform hash function. Okay, hash function will perform by the receiver, and output of the hash function will be compared with compare here, and after verification, in verification he will compare what? He will compare yes of the message with the yes of the output, and again means hash after hash hash function, and again R with the R of the message with the R after the hash. So this comparison will provide us the outputs. If the in the comparison R are both R are same, then the output is correct, means no message corrupted during the transmission. Okay, so this is the whole process of the digital signature or digital signature standard or digital signature approach. Okay, so now we have seen first RSA and DSA. Okay, now let us see the digital signature standard algorithm. Okay, so how the algorithm works. So first the global function key components. Okay, for that we use a prime number, that is P, that will be 2L minus 1 less than P less than 2L. Okay, so that is the range of the P, prime number. Second, P, Q is the prime divisor of the P minus 1. That is the prime divisor. Okay, after that, G is the global component, that is equals to H P minus 1 divided by Q mod of P. P into H, okay. Is any integer, okay. This G is any integer that is generated by using this formula, okay. And here again, H has the range. H is what? 1 less than H less than P minus 1. Here M, R and S at the sender side. Okay, so what are these? M is the message, R and S are the major components of the signature. That three things after this whole process will be sent to the receiver. Okay, now user private key. How to means what is user private key? Here we use a X is a random number, or we have used K actually in our previous steps. Okay, X is a random number. Here X less than 0 and greater than Q. Okay, after that user public key, again Y will be generated using the private key. So Y is equals to G raised to power X mod P. Okay, next is signature function. R equals to G raised to power X mod P mod Q. And second signature function component, that is S is equals to K raised to power minus 1 into hash of M plus XR mod of Q. Okay, so these are the formulas for the what our signature function. Now after signature function, we have the verification function. So for verification function, again we have V, that is verification function, where inputs are G raised to power U raised to power minus 1 into Y raised to power U raised to 2 mod P mod Q. So this is the first formula of V, that is verification function, verifying function. After that U1, how to calculate U1? So U1 is equals to hash of message inverse. Here M is M inverse actually. Here we have used M and this is M inverse. Okay, so H of M inverse W mod Q. Now we have to calculate W. So W equals to S inverse. Again we have used here S, but this is S inverse. So this is at receiver's end, this was at sender's end. So S dash inverse mod M. Okay, so this is it. Okay, after that U2, we have to calculate U2 as well. So U2 equals to R dash into W mod Q. So here we have M dash, R dash and S dash, these are at the receiver end. Okay, so we have to calculate this at sender's end. We have to calculate these all things at the receiver's end. After these things, we have to compare V equals to R, means V, that is verification function, this must be equals to R dash. So R dash of the receiver must be same with the V. If the comparison is true, then message is not corrupted and in the raw form. If the verification is wrong, then message is corrupted. So this is the whole idea of the digital signature standard algorithm. Okay, so these are some review questions. Okay, so I hope all the students will be able to give the answers of these review questions after the lecture, after learning the lecture properly. Okay, so the first question is explain the working of RSA with the block diagram or using block diagram. Explain the working of DSA using the block diagram and compare DSA and RSA. Okay, so these were the questions. Okay, I think all will be able to give the answers of these all questions. Again, I am repeating that digital signature is what? It is a technique. See, this one line is very important. It is a technique in which sender use its own private key to send the message and receiver use the public key to decrypt the message. Means for encryption we are using private key, for decryption we are using public key. Okay, thank you so much guys. I hope you are enjoying the lectures. Thank you so much.